That is what? 2 into 10 to minus 3.
And so what's 0.866.
And root 3 also, sometimes people don't even remember root 3 well. Because at times values are given like that, okay, that they'll tell you delta t is 1.732. But that thing will never strike in your head that okay, if root 3 is coming in denominator, I'll cancel it with 1 by 1. Next question. No breaks today. A circular coil. It's fun, right? You don't need breaks now. Every time you are fighting for me. Circular coil of radius 10 cm. And number of turns 500. I'll give 2 minutes. Number of turns is 500 and okay, this is radius. I'll call this as A because R I have to use for resistance. Resistance is 2 ohms. Okay. It is placed with its plane perpendicular to the horizontal component of Earth's magnetic field. Are you getting it?
Can you repeat that, sir?
You don't have to write all that. Don't write the story. Just imagine what is happening here. This is only data is this much. Data is this much. And then it is placed perpendicular to the horizontal component of Earth magnetic field. So how it is placed? Like this. Horizontal component will be horizontal. Getting it? It is rotated about its vertical diameter through 180 degrees. It is rotated by 180 degrees in 0.25 seconds. In 0.25 seconds. Horizontal component of Earth magnetic field is 3 into 10 raised to the power minus 5 Tesla. Fine. You need to get the value of EMF, current, and the charge that has flown through the coil. Yeah, charge that is flown through the loop in this time. You got the EMF and current? How much? Initial flux is what? Initial flux is B into A into cos of what? Cos of 0. Final flux is what? B into A into cos of 180 degrees. See, you can choose your area vector initially like this. Fine. Once you have chosen this, this area vector becomes fixed. It rotates with a coil also. You can't be like, okay, after it rotates, I'll change my area vector like that. No. You can choose once. Once you have chosen like this, it is fixed. If coil rotates, the area vector also rotates. Fine. The final, this is equal to minus BA. Initial is B into A. So change is what? Minus 2 into BA. Fine. So minus of delta phi by delta T is the EMF. That is 2BA divided by delta T. This is EMF. E and current is what? 1 by R times 2BA by delta T. And one thing you have to notice here that there are number of turns. What you should do here? Multiply with N. How will you get delta Q? Dekho. What is EMF? Minus of d phi by dt. Fine. Current is what? 1 by r d phi by dt. Fine. Current is also dq by dt. dt and dt gone. So you'll get dq is equal to minus of d phi by r. So when you integrate this, you will get delta q is equal to minus of change in flux by r, or magnitude of charge that has been passed across is magnitude of change in flux divided by resistance. So just divide the change in flux with the resistance, you will get the charge that has flown across. Get the values quickly. EMF is 3.8 into 10 to minus 3.
3.8 into 10 to the power. 10 to the power.
Minus 3. 3.8 10 to the minus 3. How much you got flux? 3 pi into 10 to the minus 7.
Yeah.
So 2 times of that into 500 divided by 0.25. Oh, you made calculation error, huh? That I can't teach. That is difficult to teach.
So what do you say the other one?
3.8 into 10 to the power
minus 3.
1.2 pi is 3.8. But then you are handicapped after 1.2 pi. You are not able to proceed. You are not able to multiply 1.2 with pi.
I didn't do it.
Why? Why? Any doubt? No doubt? Doubtless? Without doubt? Shall I proceed?